I'm Mark Rowley from the Limerick Post, and this is the quick sports recap of all the action that's gone by this past weekend. Limerick hurlers once again did us proud this past weekend as they saw off the challenge of Waterford in the All-Ireland Hurling semi-final at Croke Park. They ran out the victors 125-17, and John Colley's men from start to finish put on an amazing display, showing skill, athleticism and composure to see off a strong and physical Waterford side. Limerick will now play their third final in 4 years and will look to go back-to-back, and they will play Cork in what will be an all-Munster All-Ireland Hurling Final. It will be played in Croke Park on 22nd of August, and we at the Limerick Post and all of the county will be wishing Limerick all the best and hope that it can take home another All-Ireland title. The British and Irish Lions fell to a 2-1 series defeat this past weekend as they were beaten by South Africa in Cape Town this past Saturday, with Warren Gatland's men narrowly getting defeated towards the last 2 minutes of the game, with flashbacks from 2009 with the all-too-familiar image of Mornay Steyn putting over a penalty to secure the Springboks victory. The series win will leave Gatland's men no doubt disappointed, but they fought to the very end, with Ken Owens getting the first and only try of the game for the Lions before Cheslin Colby crossed over for South Africa. And 2 minutes before the end of the game, the crucial moment of the game came when Courtney Laws was penalised for not rolling away, with Mornay Steyn stepping up and putting the ball over the posts to deny Gatland's men a series win or a series draw. Tralee United have dropped down a place this week in the Airtricity League First Division after their loss on Friday night to Cavan Teely. The away side took the win 4-1, with Clyde O'Connell getting the only goal of the game for Tommy Barrett's men. Tralee United now sit level on points with Galway, and they will fight for promotion as it is still on, but they trail leader Shelburne, who's clear at the top of the table by 10 points. I've been Mark Rowley. That has been the quick sports roundup and recap of all the action that has gone by this past weekend. We will have this every week at Monday, where you can catch it on the website, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. It will also be available. Until next Monday, folks, thank you and goodbye.